Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kolhapre. In earlier video, we have seen what is torsion of shafts. So, torsion is nothing but the twisting moment, and the unit of torsion is given by Newton mm. We have seen this in the last class. So we have seen also a formula known as pure torsion formula. T by IP is equal to QS by R is equal to G theta by L. So T is the torsion. IP, remember, in this torsion chapter we are using polar moment of inertia, and this is given by pi d dash to 4 by 32. In all other topics we have seen it as pi d 4 by 64, that was either Ixx or Iyy. In torsion chapter we are using polar moment of inertia as pi d 4 by 32. Q is the maximum shear stress, R is the radius of the shaft, G is the modulus of rigidity, theta is the angle of twist at the center, and L is the length of the shaft. With this background, we can take up problems to find out either the torsion or the power that is transmitted. Suppose if I take an example, if I take a shaft, if the length of the shaft is say 7.5 meter, if it is circular, having diameter as 300 mm, so here length is 7.5 meter, if the diameter of the shaft is 300 mm, you are required to find out the torque, the torque that can be transmitted by the shaft. The conditions given to you is, first condition is the angle of twist should not be equal to 1.5 degree in 7.5 meter. You will have to satisfy this condition. The angle of twist should not be more than 1.5. And second condition is the maximum shear stress, Q max, in the shaft should not be exceeding 42 Newton per mm square. And the modulus of rigidity is given to you as 84.4 kilonewton per mm square. So this is data given. The main data given is the diameter of the shaft and the length. You are required to find out how much torque it can transmit, provided the angle of twist should be 1.5 degree in 7.5 meter length, and the maximum shear stress is 42 newton per mm square. So we will be using the relation T by IP is equal to QS by R is equal to G theta by L. So this only formula will help us to find out the required thing. Now we need the torque. Condition is theta is equal to 1.5 degree in 7.5 meter. So I can use this relation. T by IP must be equal to G theta by L. So you need T, you know IP, you know G, you know theta, you know the length of the shaft. So this will give us the torque that can be transmitted. So using these two relations, T is equal to IP G theta by L. If I simplify this, so we need to find out IP. IP is nothing but pi d4 by 32. So this will be pi into 300 raised to 4 by 32. So if you simplify this, you get 795.19 into 10 to the power of 6 mm raised to 4. If I simplify the values, and theta, this theta what is given is in degrees, it should be in the radians, and we know pi radians is 180 degrees, or 180 degrees is pi radians, our C is 1.5 degrees, how much? So this will be 1.5 divided by 180 into pi. So this is the value that you'll have to submit in terms of radians. So substituting the value, IP is equal to 795.19 into 10 to the power of 6 into G is given to us 84.4 kilonewton per mm square. We need it as 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square into theta is 1.5 pi by 180. This is the value of theta what we have got, divided by the length of the shaft given to you is 7.5 meters. So please convert it in mm. So all the units are in Newton and mm. If you simplify this, you get 234.27 into 10 to the power of 6, we are finding out torque. It is nothing but Newton mm, same as bending moment, Newton mm. So this is equal to 234.27 kilonewton meter. So directly you can convert it in kilonewton meter if you know it is in terms of 10 raised to 6. So this is the torque that can be transmitted. Condition is when theta is 1.5 degree in 7.5 meter. We'll check with the second condition. So for Q max, we'll see what is the torsion. This is for twist is how much, first condition. This is the second condition for torque, maximum shear stress. Again, we can use this relation. T by IP is equal to QS by R. So T by IP is equal to QS by R. So we want T will be equal to QS IP divided by R. And if we simplify the values here, this will be equal to maximum permissible shear stress is 42 Newton per mm square into, we have calculated the value of IP as 795.19 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by R. Diameter is given to you as 300 mm, so radius will be equal to 150 mm. So if you simplify this value, you get the value of T as 222.65 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm, or this will be equal to 222.65 kilonewton meter. So this is a transmitted power, the torque with respect to the shear stress, and this is a torque required with respect to the angle of twist. So here, out of the two, we will have to use a minimum value, because the moment it attains this, it is going to fail in shear. You cannot allow the shaft to take this much of torque, because it is already, it will be failing in shear. Even though it is capable of taking rotation, but it is going to fail in this condition of shear stress. So whichever is a lesser of the two, that is the maximum torque that we can permit. So permitted torque Q will be less, T lesser of two values. So that is how much? Lesser of the two values, 222.65 kilonewton meter is the power that can be, is the torsion that can be applied on the shaft. So this is one type of problem. We'll see to the other types of problems. Whatever may be the type of problem, we are rotated, we are about that formula. T by IP is equal to Fs by R is equal to G theta by L. So one thing is given, another thing will be asked to you. So here we'll take up another problem. Suppose if I take a hollow circular shaft. It's a hollow circular shaft. If the outer diameter is 100 mm and if the inner diameter is 75 mm, if the length of the shaft is 6 meters and if I want to apply a torque of 10 kilonewton meter, if I want to apply a torque of 10 kilonewton meter, then I should find out what is the maximum permissible shear stress. And second is, how much is the maximum rotation I can give, or the twist that I can give in a length of 6 meters. See the difference between earlier problem. In earlier problem, maximum shear stress was given, angle of twist was given, we have found out the torque. Here, torque is given to you, you will have to find out the maximum permissible shear stress and the angle of twist. So we'll go on the same lines again by using the formula. T by IP is equal to QS by R is equal to G theta by L. So first, let me write it. T by IP is equal to QS by R is equal to G theta by L. So here G is given in the problem to you. So the value of G is 80 GPa. 80 GPa. We need the values in Newton per mm square. Always remember, whenever it is ET, to convert GPa to Newton per mm square, just multiply it by 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Remember this, GPa to Newton per mm square. So let's find out what is IP. IP, remember, in shafts it is polar moment of inertia, so it should be 32, not 64. So this will be equal to pi into, it is a hollow shaft, outer radius 100 raised to 4 minus inner radius is diameter 75 raised to 4. So if you simplify this, you get 6.711 into 10 to the power of 6 mm raised to 4. Now we'll go maximum shear stress. So you are required to find out the maximum shear stress when the torque is 10 Newton. So I will be using these two relations. So T by IP is equal to QS by R. So here you need to find out QS. So QS will be equal to T into R divided by IP. So this is equal to, you know, torque is kilonewton meter, so multiplied by 10 raised to 6 to convert it in Newton mm. Then R is the radius, we take the extreme radius because shear is maximum on the outer face. It is 0 at the center, and as you go towards the outer side, the shear stress goes on increasing. So here the maximum radius is 100 by 2. 100 is the outer diameter by 2 divided by IP is 6.711 into 10 to the power of 6. So if you simplify this, you get the maximum shear stress that can be permitted is 74.51 Newton per mm square. Next we will go for angle of twist. How much twist I can apply in a length of how much? 6 meters. Again, from this formula, I will use these two relations, this and this, because we need to find out theta there. So T by IP is equal to G theta by L. We need theta here, so theta will be equal to TL by GIP. TL by GIP. If I substitute the values, T is 10 kilonewton meter, so convert it to Newton mm, and L is the length of the shaft, it is 6 meters, so convert it into mm, so that is 6000 divided by G is given to me as 80 into 10 to the power of 3 into IP, we have calculated it as 6.711 into 10 to the power of 6. So if you simplify for theta, you get the value of theta as 0.111757, and this is in radians. The value what you get will be in radians. If you want to convert it in degrees, so it will be 0.111757 into 180 divided by pi. So this angle of twist will be 6.403 degrees. So this is the angle of twist. So these are the analysis problem. One data is given to you, other things are asked to you, but anyway you are moving round about this formula only to find out, see what is given and what is to be calculated. So we will see for other problems in the next video. Please subscribe the channel for more videos, press the bell button for notifications, go to comment section for your questions. Thank you.